A Lee County teen is voicing her frustrations, wrongly arrested because she looked like a person in this video.
I was crying. I was happy. Like, it was tears of joy because I know I didn't do that, and it just hurts. I was hurt for a long time, and no one knows how that felt, and I just pray that no one else have to go through what I went through.
This week, the state attorney's office dropped charges against 19-year-old Jackie Leapheart for stealing a woman's credit card. NBC2's Joe Petrello speaking with the teen who now wants someone held accountable for her arrest and the impact that arrest has already had on her life.
Well, Leapheart tells me she couldn't believe it when detectives arrested her. She says all along she could prove that she was working when the crime happened.
Jackie Leapheart is on a mission.
To clear my name, to just get all this off my record. I just don't want to be on my record, period.
Detectives used this surveillance video from January as evidence to arrest Leapheart. It shows two women stealing someone's wallet at the Coconut Point Mall. Leapheart says she spent a day in jail for the crime.
When he arrested me, I told him, you have the wrong person.
The state attorney's office says his school official and detective identified Leapheart in the surveillance video. Leapheart swears she wasn't there when the crime happened.
I was working at Zaxby's. I was at work during the whole time. They said it happened around 3, and I was at work. I didn't get off of work till 5.
The state attorney's office says they eventually learned that Leapheart may have an alibi. After an investigation, they dropped all the charges against her.
I was crying. I was happy. Like, it was tears of joy because I know I didn't do that, and it just hurts. I was hurt for a long time, and no one knows how that felt, and I just pray that no one else have to go through what I went through.
Leapheart is now working with the NAACP and Fort Myers attorney Scott Goldberg to see what they can do from here. They will meet Monday to explore their options. Meanwhile, the Lee County Sheriff's Office declined to comment. Live in the newsroom, Joe Petrello, NBC2.